Have you ever built a Power BI report that's connected to a published model on PowerBI.com and then realize you need to point that same report to a different model, maybe to test some new changes, or the model has been renamed or moved? If that happens, you do not need to rebuild your report from scratch. I'll show you exactly how to switch your report to a different Power BI model step by step. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I've helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. So let's see how we can change the report connection to a different Power BI model. So as I mentioned, we are using the thin report architecture, and that simply means we have a single model here and we have multiple reports connected to that model. And in this scenario, we're gonna walk through where we have the production model, but we wanna create a development model where we wanna test some changes. And that's where we would need to switch the connection of a report from this model to the development model after publishing it to PowerBI.com. I'll walk you through it step by step, but know that there may be other scenarios where you would also find this solution handy. That is the ability to reconnect a report to a different model. All right, so let's look at our model and see what's going on. So sales model, this is the development model. You can see in the file name, that's the one that I've opened and that I have simply just made a copy of my production model. Now, what I would highly recommend is that you keep your production versions and even development versions, probably in SharePoint, that gives you automatic versioning. And from there, you should be publishing it to PowerBI.com, right? So that's the setup that we have. So I've copied that model, and then here we have made some changes. And I haven't finalized the changes yet, and I'll talk about that. So this is pretty much a sales model and a sales dashboard. This is roughly based on a model that I had built for one of my clients. So if you look at the target report, it just tracks how much the revenue the sales team has generated, where are they doing against their monthly goals, how much bonus they have unlocked, and things like that. There's a team bonus, there's individual bonus, and there's all sorts of other information there. Now, in our scenario, the change that needs to be, has been made in the development model is the development model has this additional deal type exclude field. And let me see if I had that in the reporting. So yeah, so let's see, yep, right there. So in this case, what we have is we have a lot of different deal types. So this is the sales data being tracked. And we realize that the employee purchase program is not handled by the sales team and the sponsorship is not handled by the sales team either. So they should not get credit for this deal type. So what we have done is that we have added a field to exclude that. Frankly, the change is not important. That's just the scenario, but I just wanted to mention that. So you're gonna have a similar scenario where you're making some changes to the model. Now, I just wanna make sure that this is not about refreshing data. The production data is always gonna be refreshed automatically. Hopefully you have that already set up. So it's not about new data, testing new data, it's about testing new model changes. And in this case, I have an additional column and I'm gonna make a change later on to a measure as well. So things like that, I'm talking about model changes. All right, let's get down to business. So we have this one, we have the file already open. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna publish it to my workspace first. All right, select my workspace, click select, and we'll be back after it's been published. So the file publish is done, and now if I navigate to my Power BI, then in here, if I refresh, I will see the development model. Now, in this case, I'm deploying the development model in the same workspace. You can also use a different workspace for development, kind of recreating a poor man's version of deployment pipelines, if you've heard about that. We will record a separate video on how to use deployment pipelines, the poor man's version, without having to pay premium. But for this, let's stay focused on our scenario. So we have this new development model, and now what I want to do is I want to take this report, or really a copy of this report, and point it to the development model. So right now, so if you look at this semantic layer here, you can see that sales targets is connected to sales model. But what I want to do is I want to change this connection. I want to disconnect this one, and I want to connect this one to the development model. So for that, what we're going to do is, first of all, we're going to open the report. So learn Power BI sales targets. I'm going to open the report, and then I will click on the file menu in the top corner right here, and I'm going to download this file. Now, this is where you have to be very careful. I know we're trigger happy, and I was walking my client through this, and they're like, oh, click download. No. This is a dialog box you need to read. So if you zoom in and see, the first option is a copy of your report and data. That is not what you want, because we're using thin report architecture, right? So you don't want this. What you want is this one, a copy of your report with a live connection. So make sure to select that. You click that and you click download. Perfect. So my download is ready. I'm going to save it in the same folder for now. So I've downloaded my sales target report, and I'm going to rename it to also call it development. And I'm going to open this report. All right, so my report has opened, and again, this is a thin report, so it's connecting back up to the cloud. It's actually talking to cloud, powerbi.com, and right now it's talking to this semantic model, but again, that's where I need to change it, and I need to repoint it to the development model so I can test my changes safely without impacting any users using the production environment. And yeah, so I can test my changes before rolling them out. And again, there can be other scenarios where you are reconnecting the file. And doing that is really easy once you figure out where to click. And the place where you need to go is you need to go to transform data and click data source settings, right? So data source settings. And you might have seen this, and it brings up a different dialog box if you have a regular model. But for a thin report, this is what it brings up. It brings up all the models published to PowerBI.com. And all we have to do is just select this one, the development model. And if I hover over it, you can kind of see that name popping up. So that's the one that I want. I'm going to just click on that and click connect. And right now, you're not going to see any changes because... Well, actually, you would see that additional column. You know what? I should have shown that to you. All right. So yeah. So I didn't show it to you earlier, but yeah, this deal type exclude column is there. But what we're going to do is we're going to make one other changes to our development model. So I'm going to go back to Power BI. And so again, the goal was to exclude that revenue using that deal type exclude field. So I'm going to click on the revenue column and just make a change in the model. So oops. So let's go in here and I'm going to say calculate. So sum, that is good. And then we're going to say the exclude column, sales leads deal type exclude equals false. Perfect. So that has been done. I can actually kind of see it disappeared here. And again, this is our development model, so we're not impacting people in production. And I'm just going to go here and click publish. Select the workspace. All right, so now it's published to PowerBI.com. So this one now has the latest changes. And now if I go back to my report, so notice the revenue number here, that is the calculation that we have changed. And all I have to do, again, this is a thin report, it's connected to the cloud. So all I have to do is click refresh. And it takes a few seconds and you see the spinny wheel for a bit. And now I can see that the revenue number has changed because we excluded those deal types. So this is great, but you can also take this thin report, which is renamed as development, and you can publish it back to the workspace so that if you're collaborating with other users in the workspace, they can actually validate the changes. So perfect. So we have published the report. And now if I go back to my workspace and refresh this. So again, if you have other co-authors or even viewers in the workspace, you can now safely have a development report, which is connected to their development model. And you can send them a link to this report. And of course, in this case, we made a pretty simple change. But often, I'm working with clients on a weekly iteration, monthly iterations, and you can have a lot of changes going into a specific weekly sprint or a monthly iteration. And you can have this dev area where different reports are connected to different models so that they can test the changes before you move it to production. So now you know how you can reconnect a PowerBI.com report to a different Power BI model if you need to. And again, if you want to watch our video on the thin report architecture, then click the link in description or in the corner. Make sure to follow me on LinkedIn and YouTube. And you can also always email me at avi@avisingh.com and go to learnpowerbi.com/download to get started with our free Power BI resources. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and power on.